American Cooling and Heating has the right team and the right stuff. Call anytime. Even weekend service at no extra charge. Who does that anymore? American Cooling and Heating. They'll treat you like family. Well, we're at the Drainage Board. Boy, it's a pretty impressive operation with Carlo Bruno, of course a member of the Parish Council, but also this Drainage Board, people don't think about it, it does a lot of work.
It does, Ken. You know, this is probably one of the gems of the whole parish. If you look since Hurricane Ida, we've probably spent somewhere in the neighborhood of $50 million cleaning out debris out of the canals. We're on phase three. We're getting ready to start phase four. And what it entails is the complete cleaning of the debris that's in the canals, the major channels throughout the parish. And it's just amazing to see these companies and the equipment that goes down through there to open up these channels. But we were the first parish in the state, the first drainage board in the state to apply for federal funds. We received the first check, the first parish, and we have, after this phase four, we should have everything in our major system cleaned, and that'll be the first in the state of Louisiana, so we're very proud of that.
You know, old timers who've watched many a flood say that they see improvement already.
Well, I can tell you this, in my time here, we have done some major overlays as far as overlaying the canal, seeing what needs to be done to them, doing those rehabs, making sure that when we spray, we're not killing all the vegetation so that the banks stay intact. So we have an excellent program in place now, and we have a great team of men working here, and we have a great administrator that keeps them going. And I'm very proud of the accomplishments that we have down here.
Well, in the meantime, on a different subject, those of us who endured no water over Christmas will never forget it, but Eastern Heights customers in the LaRondre area and elsewhere, they've really suffered, but no longer the Parish Water District is taking over that system. The final hurdle apparently was a vote by the Water District itself last week, so boy, it's a real happy ending.
It is, Ken, and look, it's been some hard work done by a lot of people, and my hat's off to Eastern Heights, the board, the Water District board, the parish president, Joe Thomas, myself, we've stayed on top of this to make sure that it got done, and everybody was pulling in the same direction, and it shows you what you can do when people work together. It's going to be a great thing for the LaRondre area. The funds are, they have applied for some loans and some grants to try to upgrade the system out there, which would include a new water tank in LaRondre, some bigger lines, to basically do away with the Sweetwater well and tank, to where the pressure will be able to be withheld at a pressure that can take what we had at Christmas. And we're also going to be tying into the rest of the system so that there'll be a backup if one of the wells was to go down. So it's going to take a little time. I just want the people to understand that. But the one good thing about this turnover now to the Water District, they have the manpower, the equipment, and the financial resources that, God forbid, if this was to happen again, it would never be this long to get it done.
There were so many things that could have been done by the Water District over Christmas that would have ended that situation early.
And you're right, but let me just say this, and I know there's people got a lot of bad taste in their mouth about Eastern Heights, but my hat's off to Joe Dupree, who takes care of the maintenance, a one-man show for Eastern Heights. That man worked tirelessly through Christmas, trying to do everything that he possibly could to keep the water going. He worked with the Water District when we were finally able to get the Water District in there. He was sick. He worked sick. He did everything he possibly could, and I don't think anybody else would have done that. And I'm thankful for what he did. He was very helpful to me, giving me answers to questions that people had, and I wish him the best of luck. So maybe now he can retire and enjoy himself, him and his wife. But I think this is going to be a good move, and I want to just tell the people, you know, this is not going to happen overnight. This is going to take a little time to get done, but I would think by sometime this year, this time next year, you're going to see some vast improvements in the water system on Tangipahoa Water.
Extending the Water District through LaRondre like this, it's bound to help more subdivisions and homes that are coming in, regardless of whether we have water or not, but it's essential for such a growing area.
Well, and you got to remember too, Ken, a lot of homes out there are still on single family wells. Very hard to maintain. If the lights go out and you don't have a generator, you don't have water. A lot of people, especially the older people, are moving to the water system. The only reason they haven't changed is because of the horror stories that they heard about Eastern Heights. And, you know, some of it's true, some of it is exaggerated. But now that the parish's system is going to take over, that availability to water and good water is going to be there. And I look to see a lot of people come from off of their wells onto the system, and that's going to make a great asset to the LaRonja community.
What else are you working on?
Well, we do an overlay now. They are in my district right now. They're working a strong nursery road. Was being done yesterday and today. Got Alessie Road, which is the emergency room at Independence. Lolly Kemp Hospital is being done. A lot of streets around Independence. We have some in Red Hill area. Some in the Tickfaw area, so I'm very proud of that. And we're also putting together the list of roads for next year, so that list will be coming out shortly, as soon as all the councilmen finalize their list.
Boy, we were in Independence today. What a great job that the parish has done in the town.
Well, let me tell you something, I'm very proud of this. Mayor Payne has done a wonderful job with the town of Independence. If you've been through there, the town looks beautiful. I don't remember Independence looking that good 30 years ago, but he's a really proactive mayor. He's done a lot of things that's good. He's taken down abandoned houses. If you've been out by the interstate, you see the new sign that's come up out there. The interstate's clean and it's really nice. And my hat's off to him and the council of the job they've done. And we're getting new businesses coming to town, and I think you're going to see a lot of good things happen to Independence.
Great news. There's someone you can call for fast, reliable service on your air conditioning. American Cooling and Heating. 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Friendly people who are experts at what they do. 25 years in business with lots of satisfied customers. Old-fashioned service plus the wherewithal to get the job done right. American Cooling and Heating.